Welcome back to Jersey's Talking. When you think of New Jersey, a few things may come to mind. Bad jokes, big hair, maybe Uncle Floyd. But your list would be incomplete without New Jersey 101.5. And tonight we're fortunate to have with us two of the top talkers on the hit station, Judy Franco and Dennis Malloy. Welcome.
Thanks to be here.
Preston's a pretty hard act to follow, Dennis.
Yeah, I know.
What Judy and I are still nervous. That's all we can talk about.
If I can get
Preston.
Judy to shut up while I do card tricks, that would be a great thing.
I mean, we're still like vibrating from it.
I've never seen her so quiet. With someone
well,
else
we were awestruck. We were completely awestruck.
It was amazing, though, Dennis.
It was
amazing.
You blew that card trick, though.
I was so nervous shuffling. I was very nervous.
You but don't blame it on Paige.
It's all my fault. Bye, Creskin. Creskin's leaving the studio. Now, first of all, tell me, how long have you two been a team?
Actually, not too long. It's only been about 3 or 4 months.
That's it?
Two months. It seems like 3 or 4 months.
No, it's been 3 months.
It's a couple.
How did you two get paired up?
Judy, why don't you tell that story?
Okay, I worked at night at the station, and then they thought, you know, I was so loud-mouthed, and really they had nobody to shut me up, and so Dennis, they figured, could do that, and he's tamed me.
And you were already on in the mornings, right?
I was doing a couple hours in midday, right, and the ratings were really bad, and I have a long contract, so they couldn't fire me.
That's not true. Everybody always loved Dennis, and I always worked at music stations where everybody always loved me. Now, nobody loves me anymore. Because they make us like, he's the good guy, he's New Jersey's brother-in-law. That's the whole thing.
Right.
And I'm like New Jersey's, I don't know, shrew woman. Isn't it true?
Were you guys friendly, though, before you were paired up professionally?
We met the day we went on, the first day we went on the air together.
No, we met once before that. Remember?
Did we?
Yeah,
oh, for a second.
But I mean, you didn't go out and like get to know each other and all that.
No, we wouldn't. Even now, we would never do that.
You would never see each other extracurricularly.
No, our silly boss said, don't. You know that woman that's on at night, we're going to put you on with her, and
You were bummed out about it. He was really bummed out.
I was like, it's my little space. Everybody has, you know, other people in the studio. I'm always the only one that had my own little space.
Hey, but Kathy Lee didn't hurt Regis.
Yeah, no.
Good point.
It's the most fun I've had working, probably in radio, but definitely working at New Jersey 101.5 since Judy's come.
But he's never said anything
nice to me before
until just this second.
We're on TV.
Now, you came from Philadelphia originally, is that right?
Yeah, I did.
And you were working down there also in music radio, or?
Yeah, primarily in music radio. Then I got out of the business for about a year, and New Jersey 101.5 called and said, why don't you try this? Because it's kind of different. We have some music, but it's sort of talk, but it's not old man in their underwear talk where you call and say, you know, the tabs are too high. Although we do some of that, too.
You do more of the old man in the underwear thing than I do.
Yeah, I mean, New Jersey's a great place. If you want to talk politics and gripe about it, there's so much stuff to gripe about.
You can talk about everything here.
Yeah, and we talk about stuff. We both have 3 kids. We're like the Brady Bunch if we ever, you know, we're stupid enough
to marry. If your spouses died,
Were their spouses dead on the Brady Bunch? I don't think they ever said.
They both died.
They were dead.
Because you couldn't talk
about it. Do you have some inside information about the Brady Bunch?
I'm not sure they ever actually articulated that, but they were not divorced. Carol and Mike's spouses were dead.
It was just
Florence
assumed.
Florence Henderson's illegitimate daughter.
I am Florence Henderson.
She does kind of look
like
her.
I'd like to share something with everybody.
She's got the hair of gold.
Thank you.
And the bottle of Wesson oil. Creskin wanted to do something with that. Last time was up. We had to go.
So
okay, back to the radio show. Let me ask you something else. So you guys have only been doing 3 months. The feedback obviously has been tremendous. I mean, I've heard you. I mean, you guys.
Well, it depends when they call and say, "Oh, we love your show. We love your show." After we turn off the microphone, Dennis goes, "You know, they were talking to me." Because they generally love him. No, they like us together.
But I mean, you guys have a great chemistry.
Yeah, we do. It was instant, and from the first day, it was just I did stand up comedy for 10 years.
So you were.
I did comedy. I did TV, a little bit of TV, mostly radio, and I did funny stuff. I got here and was like, oh, you do a great angry young man thing, so do be angry, you know, and I would yell and scream about taxes and governor and everything else, and people would love when I would chew people up on the air and freak out and call them idiots and hang up on them. And then Judy came along. Judy was lighter and did more comedy lifestyle stuff, and they said, well, do more of that. So it was like the first day we were on the air together, I was like free to be fun again and not yell at people and call them in.
Well, it sounds like you guys are having a lot of fun too. Okay, we're going to hear more about their first day on the air when we get back with Malloy and Franco when Jersey's Talking continues. And if you have any questions for either of them, now's the time to call. Our toll-free number is 1-888-NEWS-12-NJ. So dial up. Sure. My guests are Judy Franco and Dennis Malloy from New Jersey 101.5. The calls are already stacking up, so we're going to go straight to Terry in Neptune. Terry, you have a question for Judy and Dennis?
Yeah, hi. Judy, I just want you to know that I remember you from 107.1.
Oh,
and
cool.
My wife and I kind of cried when they shut that station down. I thought it was a real hometown type thing.
Yeah, I like
what you guys do. I think, you know, it's stimulating to hear people talk, you know, about the issues in the town and in the state. All I would ask that you guys do, if you can, is try and accentuate a little more on the positive.
Oh, accentuate the positive. Now, are you guys being negative? Thank you, Terry and Neptune.
Thanks, Terry.
You got to accent.
Yeah, we're not the most positive people. Dennis is. Did you write that down?
No, never take a call from Terry.
Terry and Neptune.
No.
Are you guys really listener. Down on New Jersey? Seriously?
You know, we don't mean to be, and maybe Dennis is a little more, but, you know, they brought me in there to make him less grouchy, and I think that we've accomplished that since I've been there.
My family's here. It's, you know, wonderful people here, but, you know, the way things are run, it's horrible. I mean, high taxes, high car insurance. I just got off the Turnpike Authority. We need an authority to run a road. It's a road. You got to go, 75.
And they are so rude.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it breeds crabbiness.
It's not that we're negative. We just notice the things that people complain about.
Right, but when we do positive, fun things, you know, is it fun?
We haven't lately.
Well, maybe you should listen to Terry's advice. Now, Judy, how'd you get into the business?
I was a voiceover actress, actually.
Uh-huh.
And somebody once said, you should be in radio. And I got lucky enough to get a good spot right away. And
wasn't that hard, though, getting that first job? I mean, it's like with TV news and just getting that first station.
You got to work the bad hours in the beginning.
Right.
But this was very recently. I haven't been in the business very long.
You're kidding.
No.
Like how long?
I never like to say.
6 months. No.
20 minutes.
A week.
Yeah.
It's been actually 6 years.
Wow, that's fantastic. And you were always in the tri-state area?
Yes. I was lucky enough. I have a family. I have a couple of kids. Few thousand, and I was lucky enough to be able to stay really close to them.
You are so lucky.
Yeah,
you're so lucky. Now, what are some things you were telling me? There are some personal goals that each of you have.
Oh yes,
Dennis.
To get rid of Judy, you're first.
We just got together, so we just got both our pictures on the website. Not even yet. But
oh.
I'm always getting her email. Say, where's the picture of Judy? Where's the picture of Judy? We hear she's a babe. And people, she talks on the air about getting breast implants.
Which she doesn't need.
So everybody,
from a woman's point of view,
you know,
aesthetically speaking.
And what do they know? Really?
But I'm really flattered that you actually checked it out, Paige. I got to tell you that.
Well,
thank you.
So,
no, but.
Well, actually, we have a call that we have to go to. Tom from Warren, excuse me. Tom, you have a question for Judy and Dennis?
Yes.
Yes.
I just want to know how tall Dennis really is.
Because
it looks like he's at least 5'9", maybe 5'10".
Oh, he's actually 6'4". We have to lower his seat tonight.
He lies about his height, so I'm going to have to answer that.
Go ahead.
Because he'll say he's 5'8". But you know how men have that funky ruler where like an inch is really...
I know, exactly.
You know what I mean? I think that he's probably about 5'7".
Five, are you?
5'8". 5'8".
There
you go. I hope that answers your question. Thanks for calling, Tom. He's 5'8".
You know what? Because
wait till I get on TV and ask me how tall I am.
What an interesting question.
You know why? Because I think we were talking about that today.
But short men don't get the recognition. Height is very, people are very height conscious in this society.
You think so?
Oh, yeah.
I think the short men are the ones who are out there like... You know, leaders, short man complex, they're conquering, they're taking
right,
charge,
but try
running
to,
everything.
Try to get your, you know, quarter pound of corned beef at the deli line, and they just look at it, Bud, what do you want? And I'm standing there, yeah, I got 68, 68.
You know what, you have a tall person's personality.
Yeah, well, you have to develop that.
Well, we have another
question. And I have a large-breasted woman's personality, that's why.
And Andy and Bayonne, you have a call for Judy and Dennis. This is Andy and Bayonne.
Hi, Andy.
Hi, guys. Dennis, you're right. Judy's a babe.
Yes.
She is.
Where do we send the donations to?
She does not need
I sent you an email for before and afters. I'm just making sure I get them.
Yeah, they want to see before and after pictures.
Are you doing
donate.
Before and afters?
Yeah. I didn't mean to, but somehow this turned into I'm getting sponsors.
You really want to go through
it? We got a nice collection going here.
Oh, my gosh.
And some people, we'll get corporate sponsors, but the logo has to go on.
Oh, yeah. So
thank
Nike
you, Andy.
Over here, the swoosh.
Thank you for calling, Andy. I can't believe that you would consider getting implants. You look terrific. She is, let me just tell you, women out there in the audience, she's like this big. She's a little drink of water. She looks perfect. I would never do anything.
I love you, Paige. Thank you.
Can we get I'm getting
when I get my breast implants, he's getting a scalp reduction.
Yeah, because this is a little Italian-American middle-aged guy.
Which, you know, you're crazy. Women love receding hairlines.
Well, now you can do a scalp reduction.
You know, it got worse since this morning.
Yeah, where they pull the skin. Did it really?
Yeah.
They pull the skin up so that that little spot closes up, and it gets to be real tiny. But the thing I found out is that I have these very prominent eyebrows, and I'd be like this. I'd be like surprised.
It would be like hair. It would be like hair man from the eyes.
I look like totally shocked all day.
Oh, I think you look great. Now, Judy, my producers want you to measure Dennis and measure yourself.
Oh!
Height-wise.
Yes. Okay.
You were thinking what I was thinking.
Stand up. Seriously?
This is a family show.
Can I stand up? Because I'm wired.
Yes, actually, I think, there you go.
Can we do this?
Yeah, go ahead. Okay. I'm 5'8".
Step on this.
Okay.
Because this is really, this is our big controversy at the station.
Okay, with or without hair, how are you measuring him? With or without hair?
Oh, after pre-scalp reduction, he will be 69 inches.
What is
69? No, I'm sorry, 68 inches.
Okay, let's do our math.
That's 5'8".
Oh my God, I'm sorry, I stand corrected.
Dennis?
Because I'm stocky and powerful.
I thought you were taller than that.
Really?
Like I said, you have a tall person's personality, and you have a busty woman's personality, so don't get surgery.
See, I thought this was
going to
be for me.
Don't get the scalp reduction.
We
are out of time. You guys have got to come back and visit us, will you?
We will. It was a pleasure.
Post-surgery?
Yeah, well, it's both of us.
Can we do before and after shots, maybe? Thank you so much.
Well, you got my before shot. It's up to you to get hers.
And everybody be sure and tune into them on New Jersey's 101.5, Judy and Dennis in the Morning. Or called Franco Malloy in the Morning. What's your moniker?
Judy and Dennis. Dennis and Judy, I'm sorry.
Sorry about that. Regis and Kathy Lee, Dennis and Judy. Well, after the break, he's billed as a certified lunatic to the master of the impossible, juggler, contortionist, magician, Tomasz Kubinek joins us next to talk about his big New York City performances. Stay with us.